दीपक और आप देख रहे हैं दीपक ही करना। टुडे इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज योर अल्टरनेटिंग करंट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू सी व्हाट डज इट मीन करंट। व्हाट इज करंट? करंट मींस इट इज द फ्लो ऑफ रेट ऑफ चार्ज। ओके, एंड वी आर हैविंग थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ करंट, दैट इज डायरेक्ट करंट, डीसी, ऑलरेडी वी हैव टॉक अबाउट दिस थिंग्स। नेक्स्ट वन इज योर वेरिंग करंट, वेरिंग करंट, एंड थर्ड वन इज योर अल्टरनेटिंग करंट। व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट करंट हियर? इन द डायरेक्ट करंट द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ करंट इज कॉन्स्टेंट और इक्वल, एंड इट इज ऑलवेज यूनिट डिरेक्शनल। डिरेक्शन इज यूनिट डिरेक्शनल, दैट मीन्स डिरेक्शन इज ऑलवेज इन वन डिरेक्शन। ओके, सो दिस इज योर डायरेक्ट करंट। एक वायर है, इस वायर में करंट एक ही डिरेक्शन में जाएगा, एंड द वैल्यू इज ऑलवेज एक कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यू, मीन्स 5 एम्पियर जा रहा है, मतलब 5 एम्पियर इज ऑलवेज फ्लोइंग थ्रू दिस वायर और कंडक्टर। इट इज डायरेक्ट करंट। व्हाट इज द ग्राफ? वी कैन ड्रॉ हियर। सपोज दिस इज टाइम एक्सिस एंड दिस इज योर करंट, देन दिस इज आवर डीसी हैविंग द वैल्यू आई नॉट। ओके, सो 5 एम्पियर जा रहा है, मतलब ऑलवेज इट इज 5 एम्पियर इन वन डिरेक्शन। दिस इज द ग्राफ ऑफ डीसी। ओके, सेकेंड इज द वेरिंग करंट, दैट मीन्स हुज मैग्नीट्यूड इज चेंजिंग एंड इट्स डिरेक्शन आइदर इन वन डिरेक्शन और इट मे बी इन ऑपोजिट डिरेक्शन। ओके, सो इसका ग्राफ कैसा हो सकता है? दिस इज टाइम एक्सिस, सपोज दिस इज करंट, देन द वैल्यू इज चेंजिंग। Whenever time increases, at that time the value changes. Here it is always increase here, but it may be increase or decrease. कुछ भी हो सकता है, like this. Okay, so the magnitude of the current is varying. That current is called varying current. Then what is alternating current? What is alternating current? Let's write the definition. That means the current whose magnitude changes continuously with time and the direction reverses periodically. That means here magnitude changes with time and direction reverses periodically. Suppose it is one wire, so current kya hoga? Current will vary, current will changes its value with respect to time and the direction of current will change. सपोज 5 माइक्रोसेकेंड के लिए इस तरफ जा रहा है, देन 5 माइक्रोसेकेंड के लिए किस तरफ जाएगा? इन दिस डिरेक्शन। राइट, सो पीरियोडिकली द डिरेक्शन ऑफ द करंट इज चेंजिंग। ओके, एक दिशा में जा रहा है, मतलब फिर कुछ वक्त के बाद दूसरे दिशा में जाएगा। ओके, सो उसको बोलते हैं अल्टरनेटिंग करंट। सिंस द डिरेक्शन इज अल्टर, direction is altered in a given time period, that's why this current is called alternating current. Okay, so what is the graph? How can we represent it? So graph kya hoga? This is time axis, this is current, then graph will be like this. Okay, so this is time t equal to 0, this is half time t half, and this is full time period t. Capital T is the time period. Again, this is the maximum value, which is I naught. Similarly, here is also same maximum value, but it is in opposite direction. That's why it is minus I naught. This one is positive I naught. This is the time period. Okay. As all of us know that induced EMF in a coil which rotates in a magnetic field is what expression is E equal to E naught sin omega t, and E naught is equal to n b a omega, where n is the number of turns, कितने बार उसको घुमाए हैं, yes or no? कितने बार वो उसका टर्न है, कितना टर्न है. B is the magnetic field, A is the area bounded by that coil, and omega is the angular velocity or angular frequency of that coil, okay, through which it rotates. क्या कितना जोर से वो घूम रहा है, that is the angular frequency or angular velocity. So E naught is one constant, and E is equal to E naught sin omega t. This is the EMF induced. This is the theory of AC already we have discussed, and this is your sinusoidal function because it consists of sine function. That's why it is called the sinusoidal function. So E equal to E naught sin omega t. अगर किसी भी कंडक्टर में EMF है, then what is the current? Current is equal to what? Current is equal to E divided by R, where R is the resistance of that conductor. Coil का अगर R resistance है, then I is equal to E by R. When it is closed, the current will flow. So I is equal to E by R, which is equal to E naught divided by R sin omega t. And this can be written as I is equal to I naught sin omega t. This is the alternating current what we will get through the coil when it is rotated inside the magnetic field. Okay, so ye ho gaya I equal to I naught sin omega t, where I naught is the maximum value or peak value, or we can say amplitude. I naught is equal to what? I naught is equal to E naught divided by R. So there are three terms. This expression consists of three terms. This is your first one, amplitude, or we can say peak value. Okay, what is that one? You can write the definition also. Amplitude, that is the maximum value attained by the alternating current. The maximum value attained by the alternating current in either direction of the current is called the peak value or amplitude. Got my point? So I naught is this one. This is the maximum value attained by the alternating current in either direction of the current. That is our peak value or amplitude value. Next one is your time period. What does it mean, time period? Here it is capital T. So what is time period? Time period is the time taken by the alternating current to complete one cycle, or to complete one revolution, or to complete one circuit. But it one cycle, एक cycle करने के लिए, मतलब इधर से शुरू होके इधर जाने के लिए जितना time उसको लग रहा है, that is the time period of this alternating current. Here we are saying this wave as alternating current. This signal is your alternating current. So this is the time period for this alternating current. Got my point? Or this one is the half time period. Okay. So what is the unit? Unit is second. SI unit is second. Next one is your frequency. Next one is your frequency. What is it? Frequency. Frequency, again, it is the number of revolutions, the number of cycles, or the number of circles completed per unit time. Okay, per unit time. Suppose ले लेते हैं 1 second. 1 second में ये जो एक बार हो रहा है कि नहीं, ये कितना बार हो रहा है ऐसा? That means particle कितना बार vibration होता है 1 second में? That will give the frequency. Okay, कितना बार होता है? What my point? इसको अगर represent करोगे, so suppose the particle is moving in this circle. ओके, सो इसको रिप्रेजेंट करोगे तो ऐसा ही होगा, व्हेन द बॉडी इज मूविंग इन वन सर्किल. ओके, सो वन रोटेशन हो गया. सो दैट इज द टाइम टेकन टू कंप्लीट वन रोटेशन इज योर टाइम पीरियड, एंड द नंबर ऑफ रोटेशन कंप्लीटेड पर यूनिट टाइम इज कॉल्ड द फ्रीक्वेंसी, मतलब एक सेकंड में वो कितना बार घूम रहा है, दैट विल कॉल्ड एज फ्रीक्वेंसी. सिमिलरली हियर इज आल्सो सेम थिंग, हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ साइकिल्स कंप्लीटेड बाय अल्टरनेटिंग करंट इन 1 second और इन 1 unit टाइम. ओके, दैट इज आवर फ्रीक्वेंसी. इन आवर होम इन जनरल द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ एसी इज 50 hertz. 50 hertz, hertz इज द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी. दैट मींस वी कैन से दैट दिस इज 50 cycles per second. एक सेकंड में कितना बार आगे जा रहा है पीछे आ रहा है, 50 times. गॉट माय पॉइंट? सो 50 times इट इज रिवर्सिंग इट्स डिरेक्शन, इसीलिए हमें पता नहीं चलता है किस दिशा में वो फ्लो कर रहा है. गॉट इट? सो बट इन यूएसए इट इज 60 hertz. इन यूएसए द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ एसी इज 60 hertz. अगेन कैन बी रिटन एज व्हाट, दिस इज आई नॉट साइन ओमेगा टी. सो हियर आई नॉट साइन, दिस कैन बी रिटन एज 2π/T/T, और वी कैन राइट 1/T इज इक्वल टू एफ फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो दिस इज आई नॉट साइन 2π/F(t). ओके, सो दिस ऑल दिस एक्सप्रेशन आर सेम, बिलोंगिंग टू सेम अल्टरनेटिंग करंट. नेक्स्ट वी विल सी दैट व्हाट शुड बी द वैल्यू ऑफ मीन और एवरेज वैल्यू ऑफ अल्टरनेटिंग करंट. ये हो गया अल्टरनेटिंग करंट. ओके, दिस इज आई इक्वल टू आई नॉट साइन ओमेगा टी. सो व्हाट शुड बी द एवरेज वैल्यू और मीन वैल्यू ऑफ एसी ओवर वन कॉम्प्लीट साइकिल. एक कॉम्प्लीट साइकिल में, दैट मींस एक कॉम्प्लीट टाइम पीरियड में, व्हाट शुड बी द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस वन. ये क्या है, पॉजिटिव, एंड दिस वन इज नेगेटिव, एंड सिंस बोथ आर हैविंग सेम मैग्नीट्यूड इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन, सो ऑब्वियसली द वैल्यू मस्ट कम एज 0. ओके, क्या होना चाहिए, 0 होना चाहिए, क्योंकि ये पॉजिटिव है ये नेगेटिव है. सो ये पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन में हो गया, ये नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन में हो गया, सेम मैग्नीट्यूड, सो दे विल कैंसिल ईच अदर. एक पॉजिटिव में हो गया +5, सपोज दिस इज -5, +5 -5 will cancel each other and it will become 0. Okay, so complete cycle में कितना होगा, 0. Let's prove by the integration technique. So here is the derivation, we can say the expression for average or mean value of AC over a complete cycle, over one full time period. Okay, let's consider I equal to I naught sin omega t, that is the alternating current. Again, what we know, I equal to dq/dt, so dq equal to I dot dt. Again, the total charge flow through the complete circuit, it is this charge is flowing for small time dt. So what is the total charge flowing through the complete circuit means, now we have to do the integration technique, and since for full cycle we will replace this lower limit as 0 and upper limit as capital T, because capital T is the total time period. So from 0 to T we have to integrate here. Okay, so Q is equal to, again put here dQ is equal to I dt, and in place of I again we have to put this one. So now the integration is like this, integration of sin omega t dt. So this equal to I naught, sin ka kya hoga, so sin ka minus cos omega, and cos omega t divided by omega, this is the constant. Okay, so it will be divided, kyunki chain rule ke hisab se ye division ho jayega. Okay, so I naught by omega, omega is equal to what again, 2π/T, so I have written here. Similarly, this is minus cos omega t, minus cos omega means 2π/T into t. Here minus and minus, so it is become plus, plus cos omega, this is 2π/T into 0, so this is cos 0. So what is the value, t, t will cancel each other, so cos 2π is 1 and it is minus, so minus 1, this one is 1, so minus 1 plus 1 कितना होगा, 0. So total charge फ्लोज थ्रू द कॉम्प्लीट सर्किट, मतलब कॉम्प्लीट सर्किट में है एक साइकिल में कितना चार्ज फ्लो कर रहा है, जीरो चार्ज फ्लो कर रहा है, क्यों, चार्ज थोड़ा उधर जा रहा है, चार्ज थोड़ा इधर हो रहा है, इसीलिए चार्ज फ्लो कितना हो रहा है, जीरो हो रहा है। Therefore, total I is equal to what? Q by T, where T is the time period. Okay, so Q by T, which is equal to zero. So our value becomes zero. So what we have observed here, that means mean or average value for AC is equal to zero. So इधर क्या दिखाई दे रहा है तुम्हें? So time axis हो गया, this is current. So total, this one is positive and this one is your negative, so both are cancelling each other, giving the value as zero. Okay, so what we will do next, what should we do? We have to deduct this part, that means we have to deduct one part, one half period. So this is T by 2, this is 2, so we have to neglect this second part, negative part. Got it? So now we will have only positive part. That means we have to calculate mean or average value of AC over half period, over half circuit of AC. That we have to calculate. Okay? This is the derivation for mean or average value of alternating current during half cycle of alternating current. Okay? So what we have to do, because it is over half period, we will consider the integration technique from 0 to T by 2. Okay, whatever we have discussed in full period, now we will reduce to half. So everything are same here, but this is your half cycle, that's why it is from 0 to T by 2. Okay, so Q is equal to 0 to T by 2 dQ. So this one we will replace as I not sin omega t, and it is from 0 to T by 2. So here is also same thing. Okay. Now in place of T, we will put T by 2 and here 0. So this one will become as what? Minus, this is cos pi. So cos pi is minus 1. So minus minus plus, and it is also plus. Okay. So now we will get its one as 2. So 2, 2 again will cancel. So I naught t divided by pi. I naught t divided by pi. Again, we have to calculate the current here. So current I is equal to, this is the total charge flowing, divided by time. What time we will consider? T by 2. Because we are considering half cycle. So this is T by 2. So this is the last expression, that 2 I naught divided by pi. So I is equal to 2 I naught divided by pi. Again, by putting the value of pi, pi is equal to 22 by 7 or 3.14, then we will get this is 0.637 I naught. So whenever we are drawing this one, this is our alternating current, and it is suppose I naught, then above this one, that means above of middle of this one, because this is greater than 0.5 I naught. So above this one we are getting 0.637 I naught. Okay, this one, that is the average value during only half cycle, during only half cycle, that is from 0 to T by 2. Got my point? Okay, but here is also one problem we can see. Why? Because we are neglecting the second part or second period. So what should be the procedure, or how can we get the exact value by considering this negative also? Okay, how is it possible? So for that, what we have done, that first of all we have to square this term. So we have to square this one, then we will calculate mean, then we have to reduce as root. Got it? So first of all kya karenge, first square करेंगे, उसके बाद क्या करेंगे, mean करेंगे, उसके बाद root करेंगे. So we will get other term as root mean square current, root mean square current of AC. Now we can see root mean square or virtual value or effective value of AC. this is the definition of root mean square heating. That is, the direct current which produces same heating effect, while it flows in a resistor during some time, as produced by an alternating current when it flows in same resistor during same time. मतलब एक रजिस्टर है, उसमें कुछ डीसी जा रहा है और ये डीसी कुछ टाइम के लिए जा रहा है. दैट मींस वी विल गेट H इक्वल टू I स्क्वायर आर टी. यस और नो? H इज इक्वल टू I स्क्वायर आर टी. सो अभी ये डीसी के वजह सपोज I इफेक्टिव और I आरएमएस अगर इसमें जा रहा है, देन सेम हीट विल प्रोड्यूस I इफेक्टिव स्क्वायर R into total time. This time is nothing but the time period of the complete cycle. Okay? So, ये दोनों सेम होना चाहिए. So, here, what we will do? H equal to I square R. This one, suppose we are considering small time dt, then we will consider for total time. We are considering for total time. So, this heat must be equal to this heat. That we can call this one as this current as the IRMS for this AC. What my point? मतलब क्या समझ में आया कि नहीं? एक रजिस्टर ले लिया, okay? रजिस्टर R value ले लिया. उसमें कितना टाइम लेंगे? दोनों में बराबर टाइम. Got it? Equal time. इसमें भी T और इसमें भी 0 से T. Okay? I square R dT क्या हुआ? Heat produced due to this resistor when current I flows through time, dt small time. Okay, so total 0 से t होने के लिए कितना तुम्हारा heat इसमें produce हो रहा है? So this is the integration technique. Similarly, I effective जैसे भी हो रहा है, जो भी current है, so उसका value I square RT जो value दे रहा है, वही same heat इसके साथ होना चाहिए. Then we can call this current is called IRMS. But it same heating effect देना चाहिए. That will be called as your I effective or we can say IRMS or this one is your virtual. Virtual क्यों बोलते हैं? क्योंकि दिखाई नहीं देता है ये current. Current क्या है? तो positive एक बार है, तो एक बार negative है. But we are considering this as the positive. Why? Because we are squaring it. But it so if we will equate this to, then what we are getting? Suppose if we are equating this one, then what should be the value of I effective? So this T is here, so this is 1 by T, okay, and RR will cancel each other. So I effective square here, so this one is like this. So this is the value of IRMS. IRMS is equal to root under of 1 by T 0 to T I square dt. ये हो गया तुम्हारा आई आर एम एस वैल्यू. व्हाट माय पॉइंट? क्या क्या मैंने दोनों को इक्वेट कर दिया. ओके, आई विल राइट एंड वी विल डिराइव दिस वन. व्हाट शुड बी द वैल्यू? दिस इज द डेरिवेशन फॉर आई आर एम एस वैल्यू. ऑलरेडी आई टोल्ड आई आर एम एस मीन्स द डायरेक्ट करंट व्हिच फ्लोज थ्रू द रेजिस्टर फॉर सम टाइम, देन द हीटिंग इफेक्ट produced due to that DC is equal to the alternating current, then that alternating current is the IRMS value. Okay, so here consider that I equal to I naught sin omega t, IRMS is equal to this one. So how can we recognize this one? कैसे इसको लिखेंगे? देखो पहले क्या होगा, पहले square I square and उसके बाद mean of this one. उसको क्या कर रहे हैं? एडिशन कर रहे हैं. आई स्क्वायर हो गया स्क्वायरिंग टर्म. और एक उसके बाद मीन कर रहे हैं, दिस इज द एवरेज वन, एंड उसके बाद रूट. और एक सो रूट मीन स्क्वायर. सो पहले स्क्वायर कर लेना, उसके बाद मीन निकाल लेना, उसके बाद रूट कर देना. और एक सो वी आर गेटिंग आई आर एम एस वैल्यू. सो आई आर एम एस इज इक्वल टू this one, this is the expression. So first we have to replace here. So I have calculated 0 to t integration I square dt. So here we have replaced this one. Since it is square term, sin square term, so we are using this one. Okay, 2 sin square theta is equal to what? 1 minus cos 2 theta. Okay, that formula here we are going to use. Okay, so sin square this one means 1 minus cos of twice that one divided by 2. Integration we have to do here. Okay, then all the constant of we can take it out, I naught square and this one too. So this one I naught square divided by 2 and this one is 1 is there. So 1 into dt, dt from 0 to t. Again this is the second term. Okay, so this one I have done it. So after the integration, here is also same thing. You have to use sine 2 omega t final minus sine initial which is 0. So after getting this, after putting this one, we are getting as I naught square into t divided by 2. This is the value of only this much thing. Only this much of thing. Okay. So now we will replace here. So I naught square t divided by 2. T again will it will cancel. So what remains here? I naught square again root under. So this is I naught and this is 2 root under of 2. So this is I naught divided by 2. This is the IRMS value. And when we will put root 2 value, at that time we will get 0.707 I naught. Okay, this is our IRMS value. What should be the value of this one? I average for half cycle. For half cycle, we got 0.637 I naught. Okay, so this is larger than this one. Why? Because we are using two periods. Yes or no? This period and this one. So total period we are considering here. Here we are squaring first of all, then doing mean, then we are again square root we are doing. Got it? So this is the value we are getting. This is the expression we need in the numericals. So in numericals, if it is been written that I is equal to sum phi sine, in place of omega it is written 2 pi, suppose 100 t, then this phi is your amplitude, that means I naught. From this I naught you can calculate IRMS value, and IRMS is the value which will give in your numerical. Numerical में जो दिया जाएगा specific अगर नहीं करेगा कि peak value है, maximum value है, then you will consider the RMS value. In your numerical, in your problem, if it is not given, only written the value of current, then you must consider that one as RMS value. और RMS value अगर पता है, then you can find the I naught and you can use the equation here. I naught निकालने के बाद this one is your I naught. Got it? So you will replace here. Got my point? So in that way you can find it. Question अगर ऐसा है, suppose this is time axis, this is current, like this is 2 ampere, this is minus 2 ampere. So what should be the IRMS value? What should be the IRMS value of this one? तो इसको कैसे करोगे? How many are there? There are 3 current. Suppose this one is I1, this one is I2, this one is I3. अभी फिलहाल 7. Okay. So हम क्या करेंगे? सभी का पहले square कर देंगे. Square हो गया. उसके बाद mean add करने के बाद number of observation. Got it? Number of observation. उसके बाद क्या करेंगे? पहले स्क्वायर कर ले, उसके बाद मीन कर ले, उसके बाद स्क्वायर. बट इट सो अभी निकाल लो, आई वन कितना है? 2 एम्पियर, 2 का स्क्वायर प्लस आई टू कितना है? माइनस टू का स्क्वायर प्लस दिस वन इज अगेन 2 स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय 3 रूट ऑफ दिस वन. सो कितना हुआ? 4 प्लस 4 प्लस 4 कितना हुआ? 12 डिवाइडेड बाय 3. सो root under 4 which is equal to 2 ampere. Okay, so like this you have to solve. Instead of giving this straight line, it may be given like this, एक ट्रायंगल फ्रंटल मिलेगा, got my point? So you can use accordingly. Accordingly you have to use. Okay? So till now this much. Okay? Thank you everyone.